Hello everyone, this is MJ from MinIO. Today we're going to give you an intro to the MinIO client or MC client, and we're going to learn more about the MinIO client and how to install it. So the MinIO client or MC command line tool provides a modern alternative to Unix commands like ls, cat, cp, mirror, things like that, that you might be familiar with if you've worked with Linux before. But it offers support for both file systems and Amazon S3 compatible cloud storage services. The intent here was to make the client operate in a familiar way for those of you who use the Linux command line regularly, while presenting a more modern and capable tool that is able to be used both locally and with object storage systems like MinIO. The MC command line tool is built for compatibility with the AWS S3 API, and is tested with MinIO and AWS S3 for the expected functionality and behavior. There is a caveat to that, which we will get to a little bit later. So here are some examples of that. Take the cp command that you would normally use on Linux to copy files or directories from one location to another. The MinIO client can be used to do the same with mccp, but works with both Linux locally, as well as copying files from local to S3 or from S3 to S3. So let's go through a couple of examples. The first line here, you'll see cp file1.txt, file2.txt. This copies files locally from file1.txt to file2.txt. Pretty straightforward. Next, take a look at the mccp command, and you'll notice that we are copying the local file from file1.txt using the full path to the aliased MinIO cluster at minio1 into test bucket 1, and we're copying that file as file1.txt. Note that this copies the local file1.txt to the minio1 cluster into the bucket test bucket 1. Next, let's get a little more complicated and copy from S3 to S3. We can use the mccp command to copy from minio1 alias to the test bucket 1 and file 1 to the minio2 cluster, test bucket 2, file 1. This copies from S3 to S3, file1.txt on minio1 in test bucket 1 into the bucket named test bucket 2 on the other cluster aliased as minio2. As stated, MC is explicitly tested to work with MinIO object storage and may work with other S3 compatible services, but it's not guaranteed, so use at your own risk. From the docs, MinIO provides no guarantees for other S3 compatible services, as the S3 implementation might be unknown and therefore unsupported. While the MC commands may work as documented, any such usage is at your own risk. So how do we install the MinIO client? Well, on Linux, it's pretty straightforward. You can use this command here to download the binary. We will then chmod the MC binary plus X, which makes it executable, and then we'll move it into our path, typically something like user local bin MC. On Mac OS, if you're familiar with using the Homebrew client, you can install that simply by installing Homebrew first, and then type brew install MinIO stable MC. And finally, on Windows, you can install it simply by downloading the mc.exe file from the link here and moving the mc.exe file to somewhere in your Windows path, or execute the file directly by calling the entire path. As always, we recommend that you follow along directly with the MinIO documentation, as the instructions and versions will be updated over time. You can find the links here and also in the description. You can also visit us on GitHub and check out all of the information that is there. There are some additional examples and instructions on that page. And that's all we have for this video. If you want to learn more about the MC client, there's a whole series of videos that we'll be putting on YouTube. And if you'd like to learn more about MinIO, you can visit us at min.io. Or if you want to become part of a conversation or ask a question, you can join slack.min.io to become part of the Slack channel. Thanks for watching.